In this video, we're breaking down metabolic alkalosis so you can finally understand what it is, what causes it, and what you need to know about it for nursing school. And before we get started, make sure to hit that subscribe button and click on the notification bell so you never miss any other nursing school tips and tricks that I've got for you. Now, let's do it. Hey there, friend. Christina here with nursingschoolofsuccess.com, here to help you raise your grades and, of course, have more free time in nursing school. So metabolic alkalosis is one of four main categories that you need to know about when you study arterial blood gases in nursing school. You've also got respiratory alkalosis, metabolic acidosis, and respiratory acidosis. We're going to talk about those other three in the other videos in this series. So if you need any help with those, be sure to check those other videos out after this. So metabolic alkalosis can mean two things. There is a decrease in the amount of acid in the body, or there's too much base. Oftentimes, these two go hand in hand, so it could actually be both of them that are causing this problem. But it really all comes down to one simple thing. The blood is more basic or more alkaline, and you can determine this by looking at the pH value of the blood. A normal pH value is between 7.35 to 7.45. When the pH is less than 7.4, it's more acidic. If the pH is greater than 7.4, it's more basic. And in the case of metabolic alkalosis, the pH is greater than 7.4 because it's alkalosis, meaning it's more basic or alkaline. So here's what's happening during metabolic alkalosis. The blood is becoming more basic because there is a decrease in hydrogen ions, which are acids, or there's an increase in bicarbonate, which is a base. Now here's two key things that you need to know. These are really, really important because they will show up on your exam, so pay attention. Key point number one, hydrogen ions are acids that we're talking about. They're found in the urine and in stomach acid. Those are the two places I want you to remember. Urine has acids and stomach acid is obviously an acid. Now key point number two, giving a lot of whole blood to a patient can increase their bicarbonate level because of how the body processes that blood. Parts of it get converted into bicarbonate. So here's how this all fits together and what professors just love to test you on. The causes of metabolic alkalosis. Metabolic alkalosis is caused by urine being lost through diuretics or an increase in aldosterone, stomach acid being lost through things like vomiting or suction, too much intake of bicarbonate, and a large amount of whole blood transfusions. So those are the four main causes of metabolic alkalosis that you need to remember. Now, if you're struggling with how to interpret ABGs or arterial blood gases in nursing school and just wish that someone would walk you through it, I've got a free cheat sheet just for you and a whole video where I walk you through arterial blood gas interpretation step by step. I put that link to the cheat sheet and that video down below in the description for you to check it out. And if this video helped you out, friend, and helped you understand metabolic alkalosis better, write love in the comments below. As always, I want to hear from you, and I will catch you in the next video.